random, with no repeats. Well, it's been 11 years since this video, and things have changed. In this video, I'm going to show you how to choose 8 names from a list of 26 names, some number of names from a list of who knows how many, choose 5 numbers from 1 to 69 and another from 1 to 26, generate many Powerball selections. All right, so over here we have a list of 26 names, and I want to randomly choose 8 of those. Starting from the inside, we're going to sort that range, and we're going to generate a random array of 26 numbers. That's because there's 26 items in the list over here. This is going to generate essentially the whole list in a new sort, but then we want only the top 8, so I asked for the take of 8. So this formula right here will create a random list. Every time we press F9, we get a new list. Now, it would help, I think, to think about these as 2 distinct steps. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to shuffle the original deck of cards into a brand new list. So we're sorting that list by a random array of 26 items. Once we have that sorted, then we want only the top 8 from the list. So using the take function, we're essentially dealing the first 8 items from the sorted list over here. Now, let's make this a little more flexible. So over here we have a list of employees, and we want to choose 5 of those. To allow for more people to be added later, I'm going to make it into a table with Control T. Click OK, and they're going to give it a horrible name of Table 1. We should rename that. I'll just call this Names. The name should be short and one word. And then we're going to count. So count A, and I point to the names in the table. You see, they use the table nomenclature for us. Now, if you name your table something different or had a different heading, it will automatically appear there. And then the number to choose, that's going to be 5. All right, so we made the list into a table, gave the list a short but meaningful name, used count A to figure out how many items we have, and entered how many we wanted there in E4. And then I'm going to do this in 2 steps. We're going to do equals sort by. This is the range to sort, and we're going to do a rand array of the number of items in the table. So every time I press F9, I reorder the list of people. And then I want to come back and edit this and take just the top 5. But I'm not going to hard code the number 5. Instead, I'm going to point to cell E4. I have to press F2 here to get into point mode. Now, every time I press F9, I'm getting a list of 5. Later, if we hire more people, I can change this number and get a list of 7, or a list of 9, or everybody with a list of 17. Now, I realize that one of the reasons why the first video was so popular is that people are trying to generate a list of lotto numbers, which is a great way to go. If you know you want the numbers from 1 to 69, you don't have to put those in the worksheet grid like we did with the names. We can just generate the numbers 1 to 69 here using the sequence of 69. And then to sort, a random array of 69, and then a sort by. And then finally, we want to take the first 5 of those to get our lotto numbers. And if you're playing the Powerball, you need a 6th ball, the Powerball, and that's from a different pool of balls numbered 1 to 26, the red balls. So just a simple ram between there of 1 to 26. Now, the formula that's down in the YouTube description, and you can just copy this into your spreadsheet, does a few more things. Once it gets those 5 numbers, it then sorts them into sequence and joins them with a comma in between. And then finally adds the Powerball with PB equals ram between 1 and 26. This formula is a great formula. You can just copy it from the YouTube description and paste, and then drag down and you'll have all your lotto numbers for the day. Just recently I was updating the thumbnail images for the top 10, and I looked at some of these, they're really old, and I said, oh, we need to update these. I'll be going through the others as we go. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.